Today, let's talk about how to create mental images while we read. I'll bet those autumn leaves were pretty. Ew, that must have smelled terrible. I would feel so sad if that happened to me. If you have thoughts like this when you read, you are already practicing the strategy of creating mental images. What does it mean to create mental images? Creating mental images means we pull from our five senses to create a movie in our mind. If we pay attention to the details authors use that appeal to our five senses, we will become great at creating mental images. Authors write to describe how things feel, sound, look, smell, and taste. We should use these details to see in our head what was described. Let's say you're reading a book and it's describing a tree that has big green leaves and really big red apples. You might imagine something like this. And then later, you might be reading about how they took those apples and they made an apple pie with those apples. But the apple pie was too hot to eat and it was, just driving you crazy to have to wait because it smelled so good. You might imagine something like this. Why is creating mental images important? It's super important because it helps you engage with the text by making you feel like you are a part of the story. Creating mental images is just as important whether you're reading fiction or nonfiction. Think of a brochure that is trying to convince you to visit the Hawaiian Islands. This is a kind of nonfiction text. The author will write to help you imagine being in Hawaii. You will remember what the brochure said better, and this may cause you to actually visit Hawaii one day. People learn best in different ways. Some people learn best by listening. Some people learn best by doing, and some people learn best by seeing. As learners, we all use a little listening, doing, and seeing to learn. If you learn best by seeing, creating mental images will help you the most. Reading is seeing words on the page, but creating mental images will help you remember what you read. It will be easier for your brain to remember the pictures you formed in your mind than just the words you read. This is why we should create mental images every time we read, whether we are reading fiction or nonfiction. How do we create mental images? When we read, it is super important to pay attention to our five senses when the author uses details to describe something. Remember, when we read, we take the details the author used and create images in our mind to help us see what is happening. Sometimes, we will create images based on the details the author gives us. Sometimes, we will need to use our imagination to fill in details the author left out. Other times, we will need to imagine we are in the scene that the author is describing. Creating mental images can help us relate to characters, like imagining how a cat feels stuck in the rainstorm, or picturing a character having similar features to our own, such as red hair. Whether we are using our imagination to fill in the details or using the author's details, we need to create mental images every time we read. Sometimes this will happen naturally, and other times we will have to work to train our brain to picture what we are reading. If you notice that you aren't creating mental images, stop Then ask yourself, what would this look like, smell like, taste like, feel like, or sound like? Let's practice. Here's a poem titled Fresh Baked Bread. Try to create mental images as we read this. I watch hungrily as my mother opens the oven to check the progress of the bread. My eyes devour the lightly browned crust. The mouth-watering aroma drifts across the kitchen. The delicious fragrance sneaks silently past my nose into my brain. My tongue searches for a taste. My empty stomach shouts, "Eat! Eat! Eat!" Mother says, "A few more minutes." Now use what you imagined to answer these questions. Was the purpose of this poem to describe bread? I hope you said no. Did the poem describe how the author felt about his mother's bread? Maybe you were able to imagine how the bread smelled or looked. Maybe you could remember a time you had to wait for something delicious to cook. Did your imagination help you understand the purpose of this poem? And that it really was just describing how the author felt, not describing bread. Let's read this short passage called Beach Vacation. As I walk down the beach by my hotel, the sand is as white as snow all along the seashore. When I step onto the beach, the soft, warm sand squishes between my toes. My nose is filled with the salty air gently blowing on my face. The sound of crashing waves relaxes me as I step into the water. It is truly a beautiful day. What did you imagine? Could you imagine the color of the sand, the smell of the air, or the sound of the waves? Did you imagine how it would feel to be at this beach? If you did, you were creating mental images. Remember, these images are easier for you to recall than reading the words alone. So later, if you are asked about this selection, you would be able to recall more details. Here's a recap of what we've just learned. Creating mental images means we use our five senses to create a movie in our mind. Creating mental images also helps us remember the pictures in our minds and not just the words. Creating mental images is super important, so we need to make it a habit every time we read. And we make it a habit by asking questions about how something looks, sounds, feels, tastes, or smells while we read. Sometimes we may need to use our imagination to fill in some of the details that aren't described as clearly. This helps us understand better. Congratulations! You've just leveled up your reading knowledge and you're ready to get better and stronger at creating mental images.